Hi there. Today we will be talking about the efficient frontier, capital market line, security market line, and capital asset pricing model. Imagine in the stock market, we have a lot of choice to invest it in, whether it is a portfolio or an individual stock. For each investment, we have two very important characteristics, which are the return and the risk, which can be represented by the standard deviation of each portfolio. Intuitively, the higher risk can be compensated with higher returns. Let's draw some dots in this graph. Which are all the available investments in the market? They are risky investment, could be the stock, the bonds, or a portfolio, an index, etc. Before talking about the efficient frontier, we can think about that. When this picture is large enough, we can actually draw every portfolio available in the market inside this picture. How do we define efficient? In each risk level, we get the highest possible return. And for each return level, we get the lowest possible risk. So in this risk return panel, we can imagine the efficient frontier is the boundary of the upper left side of all market portfolios. What is the capital market line? After talking about the efficient frontier, one thing we can notice is that now we only invested in the risky asset. But in reality, our opportunity set can even be larger when we are having the risk-free asset. So now we can draw a tangent line from the risk-free asset point to the efficient frontier. The capital market line is actually the most efficient line, even more efficient than the efficient frontier, since it can always get a larger return with the same risk level. We can always invest in the portfolio between the risk-free asset and the tangent asset, which are a portion of the risk-free asset and a portion of the tangent portfolio. And when the short settings are available, we can even get to the right of the tangent portfolio. Other than the capital market line, we also have the security market line, where people might feel confusing about these two concepts. Both of them are talking about the risk-return trade-off. Well, the risk measures are different between these two graphs. The capital market line using the total risk, which is the standard deviation. Well, the security market line using the systematic risk, which is the beta. We can think about it like this. When we are investing in an individual portfolio, let's imagine an individual stock. The total risk of the stock is the standard deviation. The stock has systematic risk, which is also the whole market risk. The systematic risk cannot be diversified away. For example, like the inflation or the government policy. Well, the other part of the risk called the non-systematic risk. We can also call it company-specific risk. The risk is specific to the company, such as the risk from the company structure or the specific industry. So, the non-systematic risk can be diversified away if we are investing in a more diversified portfolio. Like we are invested in an index, the non-systematic risk can offset each other inside the portfolio. And especially when we are making the perfect market assumptions, where the non-systematic risk is easier to be diversified away by investing in a diversified portfolio. So we assume only the systematic risk can be compensated with higher return. That's why we invented beta. Beta is also like the sensitivity of the portfolio to the market risk. When the stock portfolio is riskier than the market, we can get a higher beta. So now let's compare the capital market line and security market line. The capital market line only talk about the efficient portfolios in the market, which is the optimal combination of risk and return. But for the security market line, every stock, every investment has a beta, which is the stocks or the portfolio sensitivity to the market. So for each of the portfolios in the market, we can match a beta here. And all of these portfolios can be mapped on the security market line. And we can calculate the theoretically expected return for every portfolio from the security market line. The security market line is also a graphical representation of the capital asset pricing model, which is the relationship of the required rate of return to the market return. Intuitively, we can look at the plot. First of all, we have the risk-free rate, and the second part is related to the sensitivity of the stock relative to the market return. So it is the beta times the market risk premium, which is the excess return from the risk-free rate.